Hello, Gemini. My name is Donna. This is Irish Donna Tarot, and I am here for your top secret video for how your person feels about you, all the things that you'd like to know, their thoughts, their feelings, their intentions, and their actions. So the first card out of the deck is the Two of Pentacles. All right, so this person is juggling the idea of what they're going to do. They have two different opportunities in the past. Let's see how they feel at this time. Let's click this over to the table view for you. Thank you. All right. So your person has two options. That is Capricorn energy. Look at this, though. We have the Chariot card. They want to come towards you in a very deliberate way. This is almost like a Virgo. This looks like the Knight of Pentacles energy. It's a snail chariot. So the person, your person is coming towards you. They're weighing out what they think, what they feel, but they are moving towards you. Honey, I'm home. I have a big caterpillar, big snail. The Moon card tells me that they are a little bit underwater with their feelings. They're feeling a lot of really strong emotions towards you. Emotions that they might not quite understand. So let's see what we have with their energy. Let's see. The way they view you is the Hierophant. They view you as a person with whom they would need to marry. They would need to make a very special commitment to you, that you're very traditional in the way you look at male-female, female-female, male-male relationships. However you look at relationships, your person views you as being someone who they need to make a commitment to. They don't think that you're interested in much less than that. The Justice card in their heart space is Libra energy. We have Taurus energy. We have Cancerian, Pisces, and Capricorn energy. Your person is weighing and balancing with the Justice card what it would be like to be married to you, because Justice rules the seventh house. It's Libra energy, and it really speaks to the fact that they're trying to imagine with the Moon card, and I feel as though they're having dreams about you. The Tower card indicates that some of them may have been coming out of a situation in which they were married to someone with whom there was constant drama. When I get the Tower card, your person looks like they're in a state of crises, or I would actually say restructuring. When I look at this, this person's trying to hold their life together, so it does look like they have some challenges. We get this person trying to hold the tower and keep it from coming down. So your person definitely doesn't want the relationship to disappear while they're going through what appears to be a very tough time. It looks as though a lot of things in their life are changing dramatically. They could have lost a job. They could be trying to restructure their lives. And I'm getting that their powerful attraction to you is something that's always with them every minute of the day. They can't quite get over it. You know, we see the energy of what Spirit is telling them is to take it easy, take it a day at a time, be patient. Temperance is also the energy of reconciliation. If the two of you have been apart for a period of time, or you were together and then you had a breakup, it looks like you're coming back together. It'll be different for different people. The Empress card is your outcome. So that shows me that your person, in terms of their thoughts, in terms of their energy, in terms of their feelings, in terms of what they want, they very much want you in their life. They feel as though you are the natural outcome. So let's dig in here and see why they view the situation in the recent past as undetermined. Two of coins means it could be juggling other people. So we see this person trying to make a head of her heart decision. We see them kind of not willing to quite open up yet at this time or in the recent past. Why do we have the energy of the Chariot card as they move towards you slowly? So their thoughts are that they need to take it slowly. When we look at this energy, they need to make a head over heart decision. When we look at what's really going on in terms of their thoughts about how they can make this work with you, they know that they need to invest. we get the energy here that in the middle of the night, what happens is they dream of you, because we have the Pisces energy. We dream of you as their, they dream of you as their soulmate. You are the happy place for them, Gemini. You're the person who brings so much happiness in that they've never felt this before. They want to make an offer. So when we look at their thoughts, you know, we're really looking at somebody who is not just thinking, but dreaming, feeling, experiencing things that they have never felt before. Your person has never felt this way. They don't even know what's happening here in terms of their, when they look at their life, they feel as though they're sort of buckling under the pressure of what to do. They don't know quite what to do. Again, this person's going through a lot of difficulty in their life in terms of the outer life. You know, whatever's going on with jobs, with career, with children, with families, whatever's going on, there is a crisis brewing. When we see how they feel about marrying you, they think that you might not want to marry them. There's a feeling that they feel a little bit inadequate, but they're going to come towards you anyway. It looks like they're going to make a move. We get the Chariot twice, so your person's actions indicate that they are coming after you. They want you. They love you. They don't know what your reaction's going to be with the Four of Cups. You know, they think that maybe you aren't as interested in them as as they are you. Why do we get the Justice card in terms of their actions? Let's see, we get the Page of Pentacles. So they're coming in with a small offer. You know, it's sort of like a let's go to dinner, let's go to the park, let's take a walk, let's walk the dog. I want to get to know you better. And look at this, you are their happy place, the Nine of Cups. Nine of Cups is a lot of love. So it really speaks to friendship, love, but one more cup, if you added to this Nine of Cups, would be a happily ever after situation for you. So your person really values you in their heart space. They love spending time with you. When you get the card of, look at this, when we get the Lover's card and the Ten of Cups, those are the two happiest cards in the deck. Now when you add the Ace of Pentacles, a very strong offer, along with happily, you know, being happy together, you're getting very, very close to somebody who wants to make a commitment. Now, let's see what this energy is of the Tower card. Why is the Tower card here for the way they see circumstances in their life right now? The Hermit card. Some of you may be dealing with a Virgo. Your person feels as though they have to be in control. And it feels to them, they feel very unraveled by this. Your person feels that they love the feelings, but they're very unraveled by it with that Tower card. They're trying to seek answers with the Hermit. We see that this person has very deep feelings for you. Gemini, look at this. This is the Scorpio King. It's a card that really says that this person is unaccustomed to speaking a lot about their feelings, and it is having a very powerful effect on them. And it's not a comfortable effect. It's like they're trying to hold on to their feelings, and they feel as though they feel very, almost like endangered. You know, like, I've never felt this way before, Gemini. I've never had this depth of feeling. Here it is. Ten of Cups. There it is. Happily ever after. That is what they want with you. Your person really wants this energy. And yet, the truth that they're trying to tell themselves in the recent past was that, oh, you know, Gemini is really sexy, really attractive. You know, a lot of people are competing for Gemini. You know, I want to kind of get a little piece of Gemini. Gemini's pretty special, pretty sexy. But that was back when they were in this Two of Pentacles energy. You know, more interested in keeping the foundation, not really doing anything that was going to really changed their lives. But now, why is the Tower card here? You have upended their lives. That is what has happened. You have unsettled them. All their expectations with the Tower card are coming collapsing down around them. for once, said this, see, when they started out this energy with you, it was like, oh, you know, I just want to have fun. Boys, girls just want to have fun, head over heart. I can juggle more than one. And now they have fallen in love. Now you have two cards that say they want to be happily married to you. This is really rocking this person's world. This is not what I would call something that they would view as, they don't feel very safe in love. Your person is afraid of their emotions. It looks as though they find it disconcerting to feel these emotions like this. When I get the Queen of Wands energy, they want to secretly throw caution to the winds, and they think that you are hot as hell. They see you as a person who's beautiful spiritually. They see you as a person who has this beautiful sunflower in front of her. You're passionate, you're sexy, you're divine, you're interesting. I would even say they drive by your house at night. This is not the look at you on social media card. Social media. This is a card that says that they try to actually get glimpses of you in normal life. And in, I would say, especially at night, they probably drive by your house trying to figure out, or your apartment, trying to figure out where your car is. It's a little sneaky deaky for sure. Again, okay, so now we have the Temperance energy. Your person wants to make this work. It looks as though it may be somebody that you dated for a while and then you stopped dating them and now they want to come back in. That will not be for everybody, but we get the Justice card and the Nine of Wands. This person wants to do the work. Nine of Wands is Sagittarius energy. Justice, again, is this balancing act in their heart space. You know, somehow you balance them out. You make them happy about their lives. You have an effect on them that they don't really understand with the Moon card. This is a mystery. This person probably has never, they've been in love. They know what love is, but what they didn't know was soulmate love, okay? So when we look at this kind of love, that has been very shocking to them. You know, we're seeing this energy of, I just want to be with Gemini all the time. Why is the Empress card here for your outcome with your person? Why is this Empress here? This is a relationship that is a soulmate relationship, okay? Gemini, there you are. It's about choices. Your person wants to give you a really big offer. Your person feels as though they're the happiest when they're with you. This Strength card has the infinity symbol on her arm. If you look at that, you can see on her forearm. I'm not so sure. Let's see. Can you see this? Right there, okay? Hope it's okay. What we see is this is a relationship that will go on to infinity. You've known this person in past lives. They're just having this awakening. They're just having this epiphany that you are their Empress. Let's see. Eight of Coins. This person may be a little bit younger, a little less experienced than you, but they're working on themselves and they're working on what they have to offer you. So what else do we need to know about the Eight of Coins and the Empress? And they do see you as their perfect partner, their divine partner. I'm getting the Ace of Swords. The truth is, they want to be with you. Now, this is not something they thought was going to happen. Let's see what we have here for the Energy Oracle in terms of this relationship. They want you. They're coming after you. Yin-yang energy. They love the balance. They love how sexy and how romantic and how feminine and how exciting you are, which is a more masculine energy. The Sun card again. You bring them a level of happiness and balance in their lives for which they are unfamiliar. It is rattling their cage. They want to have you as a part of their happy family. So your person has gone from this energy of wanting to be single and ready to mingle and, you know, just all this energy of just, you know, sort of like, oh, yeah, I'm over here, I can go out, I can take it or leave it, to being totally smitten and totally confused. Let's see, why is this person feeling so confused by this relationship? It's everything they've ever wanted. They really never believed in love. That's what I'm getting. Your person really thought that love was sort of a hoax or a ruse. They had never felt this level before. Did this person believe in familial love and, you know, loving friends? Yes, of course. You know, did this person believe in romantic love? Yes. But what this person did not see coming is the kind of love that makes them want to stay in a situation in which you both lift each other, in which you both, you know, uplift each other emotionally. This person is shocked at the level of happiness that they have. Let's see, tell us something about why the Tower card is here, Spirit. Give us why the Tower card is here. Yin. They just feel so strongly emotionally that you pull out the best in their energy. They feel so much just receptive love for you. They feel as though you were the fork in the road, but now they see you as a destination. Because when we look at this card, you're magical. And they think that you're the fork in the road they didn't expect to take. So Gemini, that is your reading. Sending you love. Thank you. Bye-bye.